So this is a simple application that I wrote to control your DSLR camera, either with a Wi-Fi device or a Bluetooth low energy that I will show you after, or with the infrared blaster of your smartphone, if this smartphone is equipped with an infrared blaster, which is the case for most Samsung Galaxy, but also LG G3 and other type of phones. This will work with Canon, Nikon, Sony. I will add Olympus, Pentax, and any other brand which is equipped with an open infrared interface. So let's switch to Canon. To have it work, you have to switch your camera into the infrared mode with the remote control sign. Okay, here it is. You take your application, you point the blaster in front of the IR receiver and you shoot. Okay, very easy and very handy. You have the capability of delaying the shot with 2 seconds only on certain models. It works for Canon. So I push the button, we wait 2 seconds, it shoots. And you have also the capability of having a time-lapse function. So with here a delay between the first shot, which is of 0 seconds, that is no delay. The bulb mode is not on. I have an interval of 3 seconds between each shot and a number of 3 shots. So I push on the button and I do nothing more. First shot, 3 seconds delay. Second, 3 second delay, and the third. And the system is showing exactly what is happening into the phone, into the camera. Okay, let's switch back to normal shoot. And another capability of triggering the shot, which is either manual, is what you have seen just yet, but also using a light sensor, where you have a bar graph here, it's not very visible, and this bar graph is showing the actual, the current light condition of the room. And you have this slider here, the blue point that you can move if the bar graph is going above the blue point, then the shot will be taken. If I push on the start button, you can repeat this condition. You can set the bar graph average here using the bulb button. And of course, it is working either on a single shoot or on a repeat condition or with triggering the time-lapse function. So here will be a condition of starting a shot, a series of shot, when the light condition is reached. Same thing with the sound. So you can clap on your hands and have a big noise triggering the shot condition. Yeah, take the shot, and it will take the shot. Next thing I wanted to show you is the Bluetooth low energy. So I will stop the recording and start it up again after having put into my camera this Bluetooth low energy device, which is currently running on a small lithium-ion battery, which gives sufficient energy for 4 years of operation almost. So you have to plug this device into your remote control jack on the camera. Here it is. You can switch the camera into the normal recording mode, and I will switch on the Bluetooth on my smartphone. That's it. You can then switch to the Bluetooth low energy and you will see what happens. So So the Bluetooth is starting. I don't want to do anything with it. Just starting my Bluetooth device. So now it is searching for the Bluetooth devices and it is connecting automatically to the Bluetooth sensor, and I can now switch and trigger any shoot I want using the camera with a range which is quite impressive. It was a time-lapse sequence. Of course I can use a single shoot. It's working. And what is very interesting with this mode, that you don't have to be in front of your camera, you can be back into the fields with a range of more than 50 meters that I have measured into my garden. So I will switch this to the bulb mode. So I turn the wheel and we will go down to the bulb mode, which is a mode where the mirror of the camera can remain open. So here it is, the bulb. And I will show you how it works with the time-lapse function. So if I put here the same condition with an interval of 3 seconds between each shot, 3 shots and a bulb operation of, let's say, 7 seconds. I push on OK and I can start the sequence. So here the mirror is open, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. The mirror is down. We have the second shot which is taken, 7 seconds, and the third one after 2 seconds. Here I start and yeah, it is finished. So this application is totally free. There are some ads that you can remove if you want by paying a few fees. The Wi-Fi module will be exactly the same principle of operation than the Bluetooth one. So this Bluetooth is interesting. If you shut down the application, automatically the blue LED is off and the module is totally off. So you can let it in your bag without any other operation to do. Thank you for watching.